Okay, this video is going to be named New Stuff Part 7, in parentheses, New Magic Cards Part 2. Okay, so you remember in the last video that I ended up finishing explaining to you guys the cards I got from the set Planar Chaos, right? Okay, so now we're up to Rise of the Eldrazi. Okay, so the next card that's on the list is Aulis Dust, which looks like this. And it costs 7 colorless mana. And it's a trivial sorcery Eldrazi. And it's from the set Rise of the Eldrazi. See, because, like I said, the card's name is Aulis Dust. And it costs 7 colorless mana, which colorless means you could pay with any type of mana you have played out. And it's a trivial sorcery Eldrazi, and it's from the set Rise of the Eldrazi. Okay, so the next card on the list is Transcendent Master, which looks like this. And the mana cost is 1 colorless and 2 planes. And it's a creature, human, cleric, avatar. And it's from the set Rise of the Eldrazi. And as you can see, this is a level up card. Because you see, it costs 1 colorless mana for every level up. And when you start out with it, it's a 3/3. And when it comes to, when you level him up 6 to 11 times, he becomes Transcendent Master becomes a 6/6 with lifelink. And then when you level him up the 12th time and on, it becomes a 9/9 with lifelink. And when Transcendent Master attacks you, it's indestructible. And lifelink, by the way, is whenever, its meaning, whenever, a person deals combat damage to a player, like a certain amount of damage, whichever cards you have played out, if one of them has lifelink, you would gain the same amount of life as you would have dealt damage to that player. So, like, say for example, if you, like, since you start out with 20 life, so I'll explain this to you again, and then I'll tell you what I was going to say. Okay, so it's Transcendent Master, and the mana cost is 1 colorless and 2 planes, and it's a creature, human, cleric, avatar, and it's from the set Rise of the Eldrazi, and I just explained to you about the abilities for this card. See, if you got the image, that's great. Okay, so back to what I was saying. Since you start out with 20 life, since on Transcendent Master, it has lifelink. If you have a card that has lifelink, because I think white basically is the most recommended mana for cards that have lifelink, because it contains white mana. Since white mana is basically the color of mana, which is for cards you can gain life from. So, like, basically, on Transcendent Master, it can become a 9/9 when it hits, if you level him up 12 times or more. Because on the card you saw it was level 12 plus, and it could become a 9-9, and it would still have lifelink, but Transcendent Master is indestructible when you get up to that level. So basically, if Transcendent Master attacks an opponent, whoever attacked that person, whichever person owns Transcendent Master and attacks that person with it, if you're playing with that card in decks, basically, if you dealt the most amount of damage on that card, since basically the biggest amount of damage is 9-9, so basically it would be 9 damage. So if I have to simplify it down, for Transcendent Master, it would be, when a player deals 9 damage to you each turn, you would gain 9 life each turn because of the lifelink ability. Okay, so now we need to get back to work here. Okay, so the next card I have with me is Ashenmoor Liege, which looks like this. And this is another example where you can use the different types of mana. Because you see, for Ashenmoor Liege, it's 4 mana, and it's 1 colorless, and 3 either black or red mana. See, because you could either do it with 3 black for the mana that needs to be contained in the card, or 3 mountains, or 2 swamp. Wait, let me start over. So you could either do it with 3 swamps for the mana that needs to be required for this card, or 3 mountains, or 2 swamps in a mountain, or 2 mountains and a swamp. Yeah, I think that's basically all the combinations. And it's a creature, elemental knight, and it's a 4/1. Okay, so now we're up to Shards of Alara. And by the way, when I'm showing you these cards from Shards of Alara, they're going to be foiled cards. So you basically might see some rainbows or something because of the foil. Okay, so the first card, so the next card on the list is Drum Hunter. So back to this card, I forgot to tell you another thing. So I told you the card was Ashenmoor Liege, and it's 4 mana, and you could either, but the 1 colorless mana is required, and you could either do the required, the mana you need for this card with 3 swamps, 3 mountains, 2 swamps and a mountain, or 2 mountains and a swamp. You see what I'm saying? Because of the either choice of mana up here, if you guys could see it. It's a creature elemental knight. And it's a 4/1, and it's from the set. Shadowmoor. Okay, so now back to schedule here. Ooh, we have 5 cards. I don't know if we'll be able to do it. Okay, so the next card on the list is Drum Hunter, which looks like this. And it's a foiled card, by the way. And the mana cost is 3 colorless and 1 forest. And it's a creature, human, druid, warrior. And it's from the set, Shards of Alara, I believe. And it's a 2/2. Yeah, it's from the set Shards of Alara. And then the next card on the list is Mastodon. Oh, wait. And I already told you this one was a 2/2, right? Okay. But I might be explaining to you guys this one again in in the next video because I might have forgotten it. Okay, so after this card, we'll stop the video. Okay, so the next card is called Mastodon, which looks like this. And the mana cost is 4 colorless and 1 forest. And it's a creature, plant elephant, and it's from the set Shards of Alara, and it's a 5/3. And I'm going to stop the part here.